Hey guys, in this video, I wanted to do a little walkthrough of how to work with spatial data in R. So, in particular, I have a short script that I've been playing around with that I wanted to go over that produces a plot like this in R. So, I guess I will go into the details about what this is in a minute, but essentially, this is a shapefile. The black outline is an outline of the city of Chicago, and then I have overlaid some spatial data on top of that plot. And the spatial data are coordinates for incidences of gun violence in the first 6 months of 2019. So for this video, I wanted to go over like how you work with spatial data, the basics of it, and how to get a plot like this in R. So let's go ahead and get into the code. And as usual, I'll try to put a link to the code and to everything that I reference in the description box below. So to begin with, I'm just going to load in some R library packages. I'm going to load in data table for working with data tables, ggplot2 for graphics, and then I'm going to load in two packages for working with spatial data. So one is SP and another one is called RGDAL. Then after I load in those packages, I'm going to read in my data table using fread from the data table package. And this is a data table that I've already created and cleaned up. So it has 23 variables and 1,029 observations. And like I said before, these are observations of gun violence in Chicago from January 1st, 2019 to the end of June 2019. So basically the first 6 months of this year. And it defines gun violence as either someone being killed from a gun violence incident or someone being injured. And it also had the addresses for all the incidences that occurred. So this was data that I scraped from a publicly available data set. And the link to where I got the data set is this website, gunviolencearchive.org. So this website seems to have gun violence public information from across the United States. And then you can search the database and basically query for whatever date range, location, that you want. So you can basically query this public database. And that's what I did. And I downloaded the data and then cleaned it up already. So the data comes with the addresses in Chicago where these violence incidences occur. And I'll talk in a minute about how we can change the addresses into coordinates and how we can plot the coordinates on a shapefile like this. So that's the data set, and that's where I got the data from. Then this next line, just make sure I loaded in the data as a data table. Then for some reason, I noticed that some of these observations, even though I queried the database for just observations in Chicago, it also gave me some suburbs that are like right outside Chicago. So this line, I'm filtering for some of the observations. So it takes out eight observations that are not considered to be in Chicago. And then this next line is what actually will create a spatial data set. So I'm not going to go into how I did it in this video, but basically there are different websites and different scripts that you can use to convert an address. If you have the actual address line and the city and the state, you can convert those to latitude and longitude coordinates. So I have already done that in this data set. So I used a script that converted according to Google Maps, I think it was. The script used some kind of Google system to get the latitude and longitude. So I have that here. And there are different websites and things that you can use. I think I'll make a separate video about how I can get these coordinates. So, making a spatial data set, you need to have the coordinates. You can use different reference systems, but I'm going to use longitude and latitude. So, for this line of code, I say to look at the longitude and latitude in my data table from chai underscore table, and the column names are Google underscore longitude and Google underscore latitude. So, I'm going to run that. Then, this basically assigns a coordinate reference system to the data set, and I'm using longitude and latitude. So, I'm going to apply that coordinate reference system, and I do that with this next line as well. Now I have basically made my data spatial data. So if I plot chai underscore tab, it's going to open up a plot that has the 1,000 plus observations plotted according to certain coordinates. And the coordinates are based on the longitude and latitude reference system. So I'm partially there to getting my map, and now I just have to overlay these points to the map of Chicago. So to do that, I need something that's called a shapefile, which I could also get just from a public website online. So when I Googled Shapefile Chicago, the first thing that popped up up was this Chicago data portal, and I clicked the first link, which gave me the boundaries for community areas. And this is what the shapefile looks like, and this is what I loaded in. This gives you the ability to download the shapefile. It's a couple of files in a folder, and this is what the shapefile will look like when you load it in. So basically, Chicago has 77 different communities, and it gives you what are called polygons for the different communities' areas according to their coordinates as well. So to load in that shapefile, I'm going to run this line of code. Basically, in my working directory, I have another folder called communities that has the shapefile, and the name of the shapefile is this. This is just from the website. This has a .shp file extension, which is the file extension for shapefiles. So if I read that in, I now have a shapefile assigned to the variable Chicago. If I plot Chicago, it will plot the shapefile. So that's the shapefile with the coordinate information for all the 77 communities. And then if I just do points with my data table that's spatialized, and I say that the color is orange, then that will produce the plot that I showed in the beginning of this video, which is the spatial representation of all the gun violence incidents for the first 6 months of Chicago overlaid on the 77 communities. This is just a start of the analysis of spatial data, so there's a lot more that you can do with this type of information. So hopefully I'll make more videos on this in the future, but that's it for this video, and thank you guys for watching.